things in order for you, right? In order for you to pass IOS managing safely, right? Now, okay. Let me just go ahead and give you an overview once again of IOS. Okay, just give me one sec. Okay, so IOS, by the way, guys, has 7 modules, right? So we have module 1 from module 1 up to module 7, right? And if you're going to look at this, right? So those modules would be, right? So introduction, okay, to managing safely, okay, assessing risk, okay, controlling the risk. We have understanding your responsibility, laws and regulations, identification of hazards, of course. We have investigating accidents and incident. We have measuring performance, and of course, protecting our environment, right? So just simply looking at the title, okay, you could see here, right, that this course is for managers already, or managerial course, because from the beginning, introduction to managing safely, you will be taught of understanding or how to manage safely in the organization, followed by risk assessment. So basically, you are going to understand managing, or how you're going to manage safe, right? Managing safely, right? The organization. Okay, so that is the 7, right? Subjects, right? That we're going to discuss in the next 2 days. Okay, so let me just skip this. I need to explain to you guys, right, how you are going to pass, okay? Master, yung documents natin, for example, yung ating risk assessment form, yung template at saka exam, send ko na lang ba sa iyo, Master?
Yes, bro. Send mo na lang sa akin.
Okay. All right, okay. Okay, so again, just hang on. Face-to-face process, feedback. Saglit pa bro, ha? Medyo. Nabidla ko na isarado eh. Project instruction, delegate form, admin. Oh, sorry. Bale. Markings, feedback. There we go. Okay. Right. So, how will you pass managing safely, right? Let's go with the exam, right? The exam is a multi-format assessment paper, okay, which will consist of 60 items. Okay, and in order for you to pass, you need to only get 36. Oh, so yan po ha. So 60 total numbers of exam question, and you are going to at least get only 36, and that is your passing already. Okay, so to achieve the passing grade, right, in the project or the what we call risk assessment. The total marks for that is going to be 38, and only 23 will be the number that is mandatory for you to get in order for you to pass, okay, yung ating risk assessment. So once again, 36 out of 60, and then this project will be 23 out of 38. So that's how you're going to pass, right, the IOS managing safely. Bro Rolly, what if I failed the examination or the written exam? Then, which means the... requirement, okay, or the requirement is not complete or incomplete, which means you fail the course, right? What if, Bro Rolly, I only passed the risk assessment or the project and I failed the exam, okay? Or either way, and vice versa, you failed the exam or you failed the risk assessment, or in summary, you only passed one. It's either the project or it's either the exam. So still, that's a fail, right? Still, that's a fail. So which means you have to make sure that you pass both of them. Okay. So yan po ang ating requirement in order for you to pass the course IOS managing safely? Okay, any questions? Okay, so if you have no questions, I think we could now move forward. All right. So no questions, mga bro. Ladies and gentlemen, no questions with the with regards to the requirements of managing safely in order for you to pass, huh? Okay. So once again, I will be sending Master Ibrahim all the documents, right? The risk assessment template, all right, and the examination, all right, that you are going to answer. Let me give you a sample. Right off the exam. Just hang on. Okay. So for example, ladies and gentlemen, okay. So assessment pack. Or sorry, assessment number one. Okay. Maybe some of you will ask a question. Okay. Because if you're gonna look at this, okay, each one of the boxes will have marks. Let's say, for example, okay, number one. Number one has only one marks. Okay. Number two, there will be four marks. One, two, three, four. Okay. Number three will have four marks. Okay. Because maybe at the end, you will ask a question. Now look at this. Okay, the question is only 30. So, Bro Rolly, why did the question number is only 30, wherein you told us the complete number in order for you to pass, or I mean the complete assessment is 60 or 60 items. Yes, there are 60 items because each number will consist of multiple marks, right? So 30, the number is 30, but each one of them from 1 to 30 have multiple points. Okay? So you have to make sure. I-mute muna natin mga bro ha. San ba yung mute?
Ako na bro, ako na bro.
Ako na bro.
Paki-unmute na lang sa iyo bro, Rolly. Minumute ko lahat bro eh.
Okay, sige, salamat bro. Makita yung mute eh. Anyway, so that's how it goes, brothers and sister, right? So once again, one numbers will consist of multiple marks. So it doesn't mean that the numbers are 30. So your marks will only be 30, right? So your marks, for example, number two, there are four, which means there are four marks on number two. Same with number three, okay? See here, select one answer only from the following. So which means, sorry, there's only one answer to this, right? Here, there's only one. Number five, let's say, for example, put a check opposite the two statement that you think is correct. So which means they're asking, oh, the question is looking for two answers. So which means the points allocated for number five is two. Okay, so 2 points for number five. Number six, for example, select one. So which means the points in number six is only one, right? Number seven, put check opposite the two statement you think are correct. So which means number seven has 2 points and the number eight has 2 points because you are going to identify something or which the question is what the question is looking for. Number nine is one. Number 10, there are three answers. So which means number 10, you'll have 3 points, right? And then number 11, put one, okay, check one. Okay, number 12, insert, that's gonna be 2. Alam yung pinakamarami. Okay, this is 4, right? Number 19, put 1 check. Okay, number 22, put opposite 1. Okay, here. Number 25, Number the six actions list below in order they should be carried out following an incident. Okay? So which means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? So number 25 alone, right, has 6 points. Okay? So that's how your examination will go. Okay? So you have nowadays, you have now seen, right, the sample exam, right, of IOS Manning Safely. By the way, guys, this is the official exam, right? But since I have showed you assessment number one, okay, so I only have 3 more options. Okay, so because there are assessment one, assessment two, assessment three, and assessment four. Once again, you have seen assessment one already. So which means I only have 3 choices for me to choose, right? Which one will I give you? Okay, and I will send that assessment number 2, 3, or 4, right, to Master Ibrahim, right, and let him send you, right, the assessment that I am going to choose. Okay, but let me just remind you one thing. Okay, all the questions in assessment 1 will be the same question in assessment 2, 3, and 4. It's just rumbled. Got it? Right? So I'm just giving you down the link, or I'm giving you a hint, right? So once again, whatever question you have in assessment 1 will be the same with assessment 2, 3, and 4. The only difference is they are in rumbled. Okay? So, sneak peek, right? Sneak peek on the exam. So this is your exam. But that not assessment 1, but again, the same question will appear on other assessment 2, 3, and 4. Okay. I think we have to start because we might miss valuable time, right? So what I will do in risk assessment is that I will just give you guys, what do you call this? I will just give you a sample risk assessment for you to follow para hindi natin masyado magamit yung oras natin. Okay. Question. Once again, everyone, for the instruction on how to pass and of course other details that I have given. Nothing? Okay, so if there are no questions, thank you very much. So I will now go ahead and proceed with the discussion on module 1. Okay. I just wanted to give you an overview of what will happen on this module 1. So if you can see here, key learning points. So in key learning points, so this needs to be answered, right, by the end of the topic, right, on the last slides. So the same question will appear. So why is it important to manage safely? Pero bago tayo pumunta doon, okay, let's ask now the opinion of the other classmates that you have, right? So what is or why it is important to manage the organization safely? Let's try to answer it before the discussion. Anyone? Why do you think it is important? Rojan, go ahead, Rojan.
For me, sir, it is important to manage safety to prevent accident and protect lives and ensure a productive and healthy environment, then also to reduce the risk, minimize the potential harm, and also promote overall well-being.
Okay, mashallah, very good. Thank you very much, Brojan. I think Brojan has already mentioned everything about why is it important to manage safely. Have you been into a training managing safely, Brojan? Not yet.
Yes, sir.
Managing safely.
Ha? Nakatapos na rin po ako, sir.
Mashallah, mashallah. Okay, so you are just a sit-in. Ano bro? Dito sa klase?
No, sir. Bali na daanan ko pero hindi ako nakakuha ng certificate sa IELTS.
Ah, okay. But you have been to training. It's only the matter of the certificate. So you are here to refresh, bro. Tama, if I'm not mistaken.
Correct, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, Brojan, for that inputs or insights. right, for giving us or sharing with us the information that you will have, right, when you attended the class. Okay. So next question. What are your responsibilities as manager? Anybody? Okay, let's put it this way, because the question is not that clear, right? So what are your responsibilities? We are not talking about safety managers, mga bro, ha? We are talking about managers like accounts manager, procurement manager, what else? Any type of manager which is not related to health and safety. Not a safety manager. So what are your responsibilities, for example, if you are an accounts manager or if you are a specific department's manager? So what is going to be your role in health and safety as a manager? Welfare manager, something like that. But not health and safety, guys, huh? Anybody?
Permission to speak, sir.
Yeah, go ahead, bro, John.
Sir, maybe leading and supporting your team.
Leading and supporting your team in health, in terms of health and safety, right, bro, John?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so yes, thank you very much. So, once again, guys, all right, why is it important to manage it safely? It's because to prevent, right, accidents and incidents that could happen in the future, to save the people, to save the company, right, to prevent, what do you call this, yung pagkakakulong or penalties or any kind of regulatory penalties, right? So those are the reasons why you need to manage it safely. So what are your responsibilities as managers? Once again, that is for you to over to look and to overview, to look the over the overview of your department and make sure, right, that they are safe. Okay, so let's move forward. Yes, bro, Morshid. Permission to speak, sir. Pray muna ako sa mangrib po. What time is it now, by the way? Just hang on, guys. Kibro Hardon, it's 5 minutes. Is it prayer time, mga bro? I think it's also prayer time here. Time check, it's 6:39. Okay, so Maghrib is 6:42. All right, so let us do 1:10. Okay, so since I am also going to pray and the rest of the brothers and sisters, Mariam as well. Okay, so let us do 1:10. Let us have a break. Let's have a pause. All right, so it's since it's already 6:42. All right, 6:40 to be exact. I'll give everybody at least 15 minutes, right? So for them to complete their Maghrib prayer. Okay, so mga bro, break muna tayo for 15 minutes and let's be back, right, by exactly 7 o'clock. Okay, mga bro? Break muna tayo madali for Maghrib prayer. And we'll continue. Don't worry, we will be managing to discuss everything or every module, right, under IOSH Managing Safety. Okay. So see you later, guys, in the next 15 minutes. Okay, welcome mga bro. Let's continue with our discussion. Okay, with our subject, okay, once again, IOSH managing safely. All right, so is everybody here now? Dito na ba lahat? Okay, so yes, Mariam is here. Welcome back, Mariam. Okay. So if others are still in prayer, so let's just wait for them to join us. But we are going to proceed with our discussion. Okay. Okay, moving forward. Why is it important to manage safely? So that is the first question that we are going to ask. Okay, so looking at this, okay, so there's an ambulance, right? You can see the ambulance on the image, okay? Next will be, okay, representative of the organization, okay, going to the family members of a person or an employee which is injured, okay? So what happened was there was an incident in the company, and then after the incident, representative from the company went, okay, to the house, okay, of the injured person, okay, telling them or advising them that the family members have suffered injury or, let's say, death, right, in the workplace. So after, okay, after the incident or after the accident, what happened was, right, there's a lawyer who went to the company, okay, and tell them or told them that the company will close, right, because of the investigation, okay? So the incident, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, is death. Right, so there was a fatality, right, in on the site rather, and after, of course, the fatality, right, what happened was the lawyer, right, who is representing the worker, right, closed the company, okay, by the order of the court. So what we are talking about here is the implication of accidents, right, in the workplace. So there are lots of implications depending on the nature of the injury and depending on the severity, right, of the injury. Okay, so definitely, if the injury or the incident leads to fatality, then definitely the company, the operations will close, right? What will happen next? Local media or international media will be there, right, to capture, right, the news that one of the worker in specific company, or let's say, for example, your company, right, has fatality on that specific day. And of course, purchase order will be canceled. Everything will be canceled aside from the total closure of your organization. Now, in health and safety, everybody, if you are in health and safety for quite some time, 2 years, 3 years, or let's say 1 year. But if you you manage already to attend international courses like this, okay, you would know the reason or three reasons why you need to manage safely. Okay. And what are those reasons? Anybody who knows what are the reasons why you need to manage safely? Bakit? Why do you need to manage safely? Everyone who would like to give their opinion. Why or what are the three reasons why do we need to manage safely? Anyone? Anyone? What are the reasons why or three reasons why you need to manage safely?
To prevent why loss of assets, sir.
Again, bro. Sige, go ahead.
To prevent loss of assets.
To prevent loss of assets. What else?
Sir, permission to speak.
Sige, bro. Go ahead, bro, Jeb.
Three reasons, sir. Tingin ko po yung moral obligation, legal obligation, and financial obligation, sir.
Okay. So, thank you very much. So, that is the right answer. Okay. There are three reasons to manage safely, and always remember this, guys, huh? Because these are the common question which being asked by the interviewer, right, in terms of managing safely. If they will see your certificate, managing safety, they will definitely ask this question. So what are the three reasons, right, to manage safely? One, thank you very much for that answer once again. Moral reason. Okay. Second, legal reason. And of course, financial reason. So these three are the reasons why we need to manage safely. Okay. So that's why, once again, I'm telling you, right, that this course is for individuals who are ready to become managers. Okay, let's go with moral. How do you explain a moral reason, okay, under managing safely? So one of the reasons to manage safely is moral. So how would you explain moral as one of the reasons, okay, for us to manage safely the organization? How do we apply that in the organization?
Sir?
Yes, bro, ahead, bro Jen.
Moral obligation, sir, is a duty of care, sir. So employers, sir,
duty of care.
Yes, sir. Employers should give adequate welfare to the workers, sir.
Okay. Anything else would you like to add, the project?
To give, like for example, sir, sa mga machines, sir, a proper machine like a PPE, sir, and to give a safe environment, sir, sa trabaho.
Okay, just a quick one. Thank you very much for that, bro Jem. Okay, an inquiry with by bro Ronald. Mahina ba ang boses ko, bro? Anybody? Mahina ba ang boses ko?
Okay lang.
Okay naman, sir. Malakas naman po. Okay lang.
Okay. Okay, bro Ronald. Bro Ronald, maybe you, if you could kindly check your audio. Maybe i-full volume mo na ano para marinig yung boses ko, bro Ronald. Okay? So, pa-check, pa-double check, bro Ronald, ha? Kasi the rest of the guy says that the audio is okay. Okay, thank you very much. All right, anything else who would like to give their opinion with regards to what really is morality or moral reason, aside from the information that has been provided by Bro Jeb already? Let me try my intern. Miss Mariam, are you there? Miss Mariam?
Yes, I'm here.
Miss Mariam? Okay. Can you give your view of with regards to what really is the definition of, or what do you understand of the word moral?
It's protecting, I think, the well-being of the employees.
Okay, protecting the well-being of the employees. All right, so thank you very much for that, Miss Mariam. All right. Anything else who would like to add? Anybody?
Permission to speak, sir.
Okay. Go ahead, bro Ken.
Sir, it moral, I think it is the, we need to put into account the interpersonal relationship between the employer and the employee.
Okay. So thank you very much. Anything else, bro Ken? Magandang sagot. Yes. Okay. So let's put it this way. Okay. Moral, in other word, is morality. Okay. So technically, right, or in summary, or in short, yes, bro.
Talks.
Ay, si bro Ronnie pala. Bro Ronnie. Medyo nagpuputol-putol. Sige, go ahead. Yes, bro Ronnie. Okay. Let's explain the moral, right, in a very simple way. Okay?
Sir, para sa
moral
akin,
is... Na... Sige bro, go ahead. Nasaan si bro? Nawala. Okay, balikan natin si bro mamaya. Anyway, so once again, to make it simple, all right, by definition, okay, moral is an attitude. Moral is a view. Moral is a perception. Okay? Moral is an understanding, right, of the owner of the company down to the lower position in the organization, right? Attitude of the owner, right? Down to the technicians, down to the laborers, okay? Wherein we don't want somebody to get hurt, okay? Everybody, okay, who wants here from all of you guys, who among you here wants somebody to get hurt? Who wants somebody to get hurt in the company?
Nothing.
Do you want anybody?
No one,
sir.
Okay, good. So that is what we call morality, okay? Your view, your attitude, right? Or your perception that you don't want anybody to get hurt, right? Is what we call morality, okay? So that is one reason why we need to manage it safely, because we as human being don't want anybody, right, to get hurt, okay? So sabi ni Bro Ronnie, na-mute ata kami, sir. Yes, bro, ki Bro Ronnie, you are muted. You are only allowed, right, to unmute once you are going to say something. So if I called you, for example, Bro Ronnie, right, Bro Ronnie, what is your opinion about moral? You can click unmute, right, so that you could we could hear what you are saying. Okay, bro, ki Bro Ronnie, okay, so that hindi ma-disturb yung ating discussion, no? Because at the background there are some audios. When, for example, they are traveling, for example, they are talking with each other, or they have a friend, or they are on the phone, okay? So para hindi namin marinig, ano? Especially ako, or lahat, tayo o lahat pala kami. Okay, so yun po yung reason kay Bro Ronnie. Right, moving forward. So once again, everybody understood what is a moral reason? Naintindihan po ba? Clear tayo doon, mga bro? Okay, so let me give you an example. What if you wanted, or so let's say you are really mad with an asshole engineer or supervisor or manager, right, on the ground or on the field? Nobody likes the engineer, right? Nobody likes him. He's an asshole. He's hard to get. Right, he has lots of complaints, right? Don't you want him to get hurt? Or maybe in your mind, you're praying, asana, max dentiga, right? What if you really don't like the person? Would you pray for this guy to get hurt? Because if you do, right, if you, in your mind, at the back of your mind, you wanted somebody to get hurt because he is a problem, he has a bad attitude, he is somebody who a person who is not liked by everyone, right? Do you think you will at least in some way you will think that sana in this guy would be hurt, right? Will have accident, right? Maybe minor only. Have you think of that?
Maybe.
Have you think of that? Yeah. Yes, Bro Taro?
Yeah. Bro Taro, go ahead.
Sige, bro.
May mga taong ganun magsasabi na ma-accident sana yun. In real talk, sir.
Yes, right. Okay, so there are sometimes instances that at the back of your mind, you are hoping, you are praying that this guy would have an accident, right? So that he will learn his lesson. So that is real talk, right? But if you think about that, ladies and gentlemen, okay, that is one reason, okay, why we can call you as a person without morality. No matter how hard the person is, no matter how bully the person is, no matter how bad he is, right? We should not pray for this guy to get hurt, okay? Because we are losing our morality as a human being, okay? So that is one of the reasons why we need to manage safely. This is really bad, okay? But what I'm thinking, if I really don't like the person, is that hopefully, sana, okay, this guy will be terminated. Okay? It is bad, but in reality, sometimes it happens. Okay? Don't think of the person, all right, getting hurt. Don't pray for him to get hurt. Okay? Sometimes it happens to me that I pray that this guy could get hurt, but later on, I just lower the consequences down, and I just told myself at the back of my mind, hopefully, sana, this guy will be terminated because he's really a bad person, right? Nobody likes him. But again, that is really not good, okay? That will determine whether you have morality or whether you don't have. Okay, now, an owner of a company who doesn't want to hire safety personnel or safety officers or manager, supervisor, because he's looking at the safety personnel as an expenses, does he have morality? Does he have morality?
Negative.
Thank you very much. Okay. An owner of the organization who only wants revenue, who only wants money, all right, in his company is a person without morality. He doesn't want to hire any safety officers because he's looking at them as expenses. Okay. It's a clear indication that the owner of the company has no morality. Okay. Manager, okay. I'm not saying safety manager. Managers, all right, in the organization, accounts, logistics, right. So different managers, okay. A manager who only wants the job to get done without health and safety, without asking for a permit, without coordinating with the safety officer, without sending his people to training, does he have morality? Meron ba?
Negative bullet, sir.
Negative, sir.
Thank you.
Negative.
Yes, exactly. Negative. How about a safety officer who comes into the site or into the office 8 o'clock in the morning, and the first thing that he did, a coffee and talk to his friend Marites for half an hour or 1 hour, right? Neglecting his responsibility to train the people in toolbox talks, right? To do documentation, inspection, risk assessment. He just wanted to be in the office.
Negative, sir.
All right. So, negative. So, the safety officer has no morality at all. Because without training, without him making sure that his responsibility is being executed, right, people will get hurt. See, it's easy for us to say that, yes, Mr. Rolly, yes, Bro Rolly, I have morality. But in reality, real talk, you have no morality. Why? Because you are not doing your part, right, to make sure that the workers are safe. That's how deep morality is. Okay. Workers, in terms of workers, if the workers sees or saw his co-worker, right, who is about to get hurt, let's say, for example, a ladder, okay, the technician or the worker sees another technician or another worker using a ladder which is damaged already, wherein it's prone already for accident, does he have morality?
Negative.
Negative pa rin. Right. So, that is what we are telling or talking about what morality really is. Ah, I don't want anybody to get hurt. That's what your answer is. Earlier, right, during the start of the class, you all mentioned or you all says, right, that we have or I have morality. But in practice, do you really have morality? Okay. So that question I will leave to you because you are the only person, right, who could answer that question. Do you have morality? You can say yes. It's easy for us to say yes. But in reality, real talk, do you really have morality?
Actions speak louder than words, sir.
Exactly. Actions speaks louder than words. If you are not performing your responsibility as safety officer, you are a person without morality. Because somebody will get hurt if you will not perform your job. Okay, so that's how morality is. Okay, let's move forward. Legal. Why is legal reason, or why is legal one of the reasons to manage safely? Can somebody explain this to me? Bakit?
Permission to talk, sir.
Jibra, go ahead.
Base sa aking pananaw and opinion, sir, yung legal, belongs po dito yung mga permitting system. Mm-hmm. Bago ka pumasok sa worksite, dapat kumpleto ka ng dokumento. Na-training ka. And then pag-start ng lahat ng gawain sa loob ng planta or job site, dapat kumpleto ka ng permit.
Okay.
For me. Kasi bago pa lang ako, sir.
And why is that so, bro? Why is that you need to complete all those things?
To have... Para magkaroon ka ng malasakit sa tao na hindi lang basta kumita ka ng ano, matapos mo yung project mo sa ano. Kundi right. May malasakit.
Malasakit, I think, bro, kindly correct me if I'm wrong, when you say malasakit, that will fall under morality. Because if you have malasakit in the other workers, which means that is, or that will fall under moral reason or moral attitude of a person. All right. Anyway, so thank you very much for that input, right, okay, bro Ronnie. Anybody else who would like to explain legal as one of the reasons to manage safely?
Permission to speak, sir.
Bro Nelson, go ahead.
Sir, because the employer or the management has the legal obligation required by the state or any the state where the establishment belongs, mm-hmm. to provide safe workplace, safe plant and equipment, and safe system of work.
Okay. So, Room Nelson is almost there already, right? So, anybody else who would like to give their answers before I reveal the right answer? But again, Bro Nelson is very near. He's almost there. Okay, it's just a matter of twisting. Okay, the explanation on how legal works. Okay, let's put it this way. One of the reasons why you need to manage safely is a moral reason. Okay, because we as human beings should have morality. That's one. Okay, second reason is because of legal reason. We need to manage safely the organization, the people, the operations, because it is a legal requirement. Legal requirement in terms of, let's say, for example, local Saudi Arabia, okay? Who is the implementing body? Who is the law or the legislation in Saudi Arabia? Police, one, okay? Social wealth, social development, something in Saudi, what's that? Ministry of Social and Welfare. Ano yun? sino gusto tumulong? I think I'm near. Ministry of Social Welfare and Social Development, something, okay? That is your regulatory board, right, for health safety. Human Development, something like that, okay? So that is the regulatory legislation, right, for health and safety. Okay? That is a requirement, okay, of your local, okay? Local law, which is Saudi Arabia, okay, says it is a legal requirement for you to take care of your people. Provide them with PPE, provide them with training. It is a legal requirement locally, okay, national. And another is, it is a legal requirement of international health and safety laws and regulation. Andyan ang ILO, andyan ang OSHA. Okay, we have NABOS, we have Highfield. Those are, we have Health and Safety Executive, HSE, right? We have ISO. So all of those are legal requirements or legal standards that needs to be followed right, by the organization. That's why, one of the reason why we need to manage safely the organization is because it is a legal requirement. Because if you will not follow health and safety, you will be what? Legislation could give you citation. They can file a case against you. Tama no, mga bro?
Yes, sir.
There are legal implications. If you will not follow rules and regulations, then there's going to be a legal implication.
Penalty, sir.
Penalties, yes, exactly. And even jail. If it is found out, right, that the mistake or the negligence came from the manager, from the owner of the company, then definitely somebody will go to jail. Again, why? Because that is a legal requirement. Taking care of our people, taking care of the health, safety, and welfare of our people is a legal requirement, both local legislation and international legislation. Third, financial reason. Who could explain how financial reasons or financial becomes a reason to manage safely? Why or how? Can somebody explain to us? Who has an idea? We have explained moral, we have explained legal already. Next, and the last one is financial. How could we explain, sir, financial?
Can I, Jeff, try, go, sir, ahead.
Sige, bro.
Yun nga, sir, as a safety, aside from moral and legal obligation, one of the most important why we need to manage a safety, sir, to reduce the cost, reducing the cost of accident injury, sir, such as medical expenses, loss productivity, and yun nga, sir, legal costs.
Okay, thank you very much. That was a really good answer. Thank you very much, kay Bro Jeff. Master, ngayon po ako nakapasok. Mahina ang signal. Okay lang kay Bro Rojas Michael. Okay? Kay Bro Michael, I think you could, if you are on data, if you can find a good signal, siguro mas maganda, ano? Para baka sa signal lang kay nung phone mo or nung data. Okay. To explain financial reason, let's pretend that all of you guys, 39, we are 39 in total. Kalimutan nyo na ako, remove me from the 39, so it will become 38. Let's say, for example, all of you guys here are company owners, 38 of you, company owners, okay? The reason why you build a company is for you to gain financial freedom, or in short word, you wanted to get rich. Okay. The point is, if you will not manage the organization because of moral reason, because of legal reason, and because of financial reason, okay, what is the sense of you building your own company if the revenue, right, that you will get will be paid to hospital because somebody has been injured, right, or puneraria, or insurance claims, or legal citation, payment for legal citations, payment for penalties, court penalties, payment for this, blah, 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 lost time, injury, lost production, okay? Nag-negosyo pa kayo. So your primary goal in building a company is for you to get rich. And yet, the money that you are getting, your revenue will all go to those expenses or unnecessary expenses. So what's the purpose of you, right, building your own company? Okay? So that's how we explain what is financial reason. Okay? So once again, these are the major reasons why everybody needs to manage do organization safely. One, because of morality. I explained that already. Two, because of legal reason, because that's a law, right? Health and safety program, fire safety, training, fire extinguishers, right? Those are legal requirements, both local and international standards. And the third is that you, as the owner of the company, right, or an employee, don't want to waste money on unnecessary expenses like hospitalization, fines, and penalties. Because what is the essence or what is the sense of you having a company if you will give your money, right, to hospital and to insurance or to whoever? So if you don't care about the money, then don't start a company. Because if you care about the money, then it will only say, or it will only tell us that you don't have moral and you don't want to follow legal laws and regulations and obligations. And of course, because you wanted to throw money. Simple. Diba? Okay? So, again, bilang safety managers in the future, right? So you have to make sure that you understand these three reasons why you need to manage safely. Okay, done. Question. Nothing? Clarification. Wala rin. Violent reaction. Wala din. Ang tanong, naintindihan ba? Do you understand, sir, now, guys?
Permission to speak, sir.
Yes, bro. Go ahead.
Sir, so the financial is for managing safety just to reduce the risk of costly accident, insurance claim, and legal fees.
Exactly. Case. Yes, bro. Mm. That is financial reason. Okay. Because, yes, sir, again, we don't want to spend unnecessary expenses with those accidents. Do you want, guys? Do you want to, if you're the owner of the company, do you want to throw your money with insurance, with hospitalization? Right? Okay. Once again, does everybody understood the discussion? Everyone? Yes, claro na ha? Claro na? Clear na?
Yes,
clear.
Sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Loud and clear, good, sir.
Loud and clear. Thank you very much. Okay. Moving forward. What are your responsibilities as manager? Once again, we are not talking about managers, health and safety managers. Okay. We are talking about normal organization managers, accounts, logistics, right? Procurement managers, right? Transportation managers, blah, 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 right? What are their responsibilities? In terms of health and safety, guys, huh? In terms of health and safety. What are their responsibilities? Okay, let me tell you one thing. Okay. And I believe that somebody could relate, right, into this scenario, into this situation. When we see managers, I don't know, just tell me if you have these kind of managers. Managers doesn't care about health and safety. Let's say accounts manager. Accounts department is just sitting on the computer, right? Accounts manager and dealing with their day-to-day basis of calculating, computing, expenses, materials, blah, 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 costing, blah, 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 right? Accounts manager. Okay. And if you will tell the accounts manager, Mr. Accounts manager, you have an obligation with your people, with your department, let's say he is handling 10 accountants. Okay. If the manager doesn't care about, for example, ergonomics, if the manager doesn't care about electricals, all the electricals are having octopus. Right? And you will ask the manager, the accounts manager, Mr. Accounts manager, it is your responsibility, right, to report. It is a responsibility to make sure that your 10 employees or your 10 accountants are safe in your workplace. And what will they tell? Ah, Mr. Safety, I am an accounts manager. I am not a safety guy. You are giving me a responsibility of the safety. Will you give an additional salary? Right or wrong? Tama, mali?
Right.
Okay, now, let me open your mind. Okay, in European standard, especially a European UK standard, okay? General, Nebosh, Ayosh, Highfield, right? Managers has a day-to-day responsibility to their workers, not always safety, right? Remember this, right? Safety officers, we are all advisors by what? By roles and responsibilities. We advise people on what going to do, what they're going to do. We assist them on what they're going to do. But we are not the one who's going to do it. Okay? Managers, you are in front line of safety. It is not an additional job, ladies and gentlemen of the managers. It is an essential job for them. Okay? So, kung yung inyong, what do you call this, mentality, if the culture in the organization is something like the managers don't want to accept a health and safety responsibilities, then I'm telling you as of right now, okay, that manager, okay, has no morality. Okay? And if that manager or most of the manager has no morality, doesn't want to accept health and safety roles and responsibilities, right? The implication is even the owner of the company has no morality. Why? Because as the owner of the company, as the CEO of the company, it is my responsibility to make sure that all the managers will follow me, will follow the health and safety rules and regulations. Okay? So, don't hesitate to give responsibilities, health and safety, right, to your managers or to all the managers in your organization. Because legally, okay, we are talking about legal requirement. That is one of their legal responsibility. If you have 1,000, or let's say 500 employees, and you have 5 safety officers, can we look at those people, Fred, with 5 safety officers 24/7? Can we? Or let's say 5/7. No, 5 days, 24/5. 5 days in a week and 24 days, 24 hours in 5 days in a week. Kaya ba natin? Can we?
Negative, no, we cannot.
No, sir.
So that's why, yes, that's a big negative. And that is why, once again, that is why, right, we safety officers, safety practitioners, professionals, we are always advisors. We are the program creators. We will do a program, we will create a program to ensure that the managers will do their job, right, from top to bottom, from the CEO, from the manager, right, from the supervisors, and from the laborers, or from until the workers. Safety, remember this, huh? Safety is not the safety officer's responsibility, it's everybody's responsibility. Safety is a teamwork. It's not only the safety. Okay? So please remember that. A manager, you're responsible for making decisions about local safety practice. Right? A manager can assign responsibility. That is true. I can assign one health and safety representative because I, as a manager, has lots of things to comply. I am an accounts manager. I have responsibility to the management to give a weekly report or financial report, blah, blah, blah. So if I cannot do the health and safety part, then I have to allocate or I have to give accountability or responsibility to everyone or to somebody. But if he fails, right, the safety representative fails on the health and safety part, then the manager is still accountable. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Do you agree on that, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's say, for example, a policeman, right, failed to perform his duty, right, as a policeman, leading to a death of an ordinary person. Who will be responsible or accountable, rather?
Police, sir.
Police? Or the general or his immediate supervisor? We're talking about okay, department heads or the captain or the general or whoever, right? Because he was sent to do a specific task. So that is assigning responsibility. But whatever this person will do, right, will be the accountability of his superior. Yes or no?
Yes, sir, because he appointed one person to initiate the job.
Yes. Let's put it this example, because this is as close as we can get. Safety. Let's talk about safety. I am your safety manager. Okay, I have sent John to do an inspection. Okay, and during his observation and all observation, I've asked him to put also the responsible person. So he found electrical cables, problems on electricals, problems on chemicals, problem on fire. Okay. So John saw all of them. Okay. Now he put on fire the responsible person as the accountant. He put the findings on the chemicals, all right, to a logistics supervisor. Okay. And then all of these people complains because John gave the responsibility to a wrong person. Will he be responsible for that? Siya ba ang masisisi? Or is it me as the safety manager? Whose accountability is that? The mistake.
The person who's responsible to that area, sir.
Okay. There are two things. The responsible person is the assigned safety officer, right, John, who identified the hazard and who gave a wrong names on the responsible person. Okay, so all of these people complain. They will not blame the responsible person. Okay, they will complain on me. Okay, I will be the one who's gonna be accountable in answering, right, to these managers. Why their names are there. It's not John. They will not blame John. They will just ask him why this. Of course, at the end of the day, they will come to me, Mr. Safety Manager, Mr. Rolly, did you train John? No, I did not. Do you know the definition and the meaning of chain of command? Are you familiar with the term or the phrase chain of command?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if you're familiar with that, you understand what we're discussing, right? Naintindihan na lang.
Oh, sir.
Okay, so it's all about what we call chain of command. Whatever mistake your people did on the ground will always reflect, right, to your managers, to your supervisor. That's how it goes. Why? Because you were not trained. You, as the person assigned, who were assigned to that responsibility, okay, hindi mo perform ng maayos yung trabaho mo, it will always reflect, okay, to your supervisor. Okay. One more. Anyway, that's it. We will take long. Okay, I have lots of examples, but I have to limit those examples. All right. This course will help you identify responsibilities and accountabilities as manager, when to act and when not to. No, blah blah blah. All right, let's skip the quiz. Okay, let's skip the quiz. Okay. This has nothing to do with our discussion because the data is based on UK, right? Okay. A manager is, what's the answer? Responsible or accountable for the day-to-day management of health and safety risk?
Responsible, sir.
Let's see.
Responsible.
Ay, pa rin sagot. Just hang on, guys. Anyway, the animation is not moving. Okay, next. Okay. This one is, a manager is responsible for the day-to-day management of health and safety risks. So that answer is correct. And of course, next is, a manager is accountable, right, for his action that may be required to explain them to others. Right? So that is the answer, right, to this question. We'll go back to this one. I'll go to the live document, live presentation. Can effective health and safety management save you money? Yes, of course. Legally, how much as employer must be insured for? Okay, let's not put it this way, because again, the information is in the United Kingdom or in UK. So let's forget about it. Okay. Managing health and safety gives you a helping hand with your other responsibilities, right? Like, if you manage well your health and safety, right, in the organization, it will enhance your reputation. Tama, mali? Tama. Okay?
Tama,
increasing your profits. Tama pa rin. It's correct. Reducing wastage and insurance premiums. Correct. And of course, maintaining a happy and healthy workforce, which is, once again, correct. Okay? So, keep your business healthy and safe by thinking about health and safety when planning work, talking about health and safety with your team, demonstrating safe and healthy behavior, and that's it. Again, managing health and safety is an essential part of your job, not something you do in addition to your job. These are four managers. Health and safety personnel or people, we know our job. Health and safety. Okay? But managers don't know their responsibilities. So that's why I'm telling you, okay, everybody, ladies and gentlemen, okay, managers has responsibility in health and safety on a day-to-day basis. Safety sometimes is 1:50, that's good, right? But most of the time, one safety is equivalent, or the ratio is 1:100, or sometimes 1:200. Correct? Bro John,
yes, sir.
How many employees or workers do you have?
More or less, sir, 900.
900. Ilang kayong safety?
I think, sir, if I'm not mistaken, 12, sir.
12. So if you will calculate the ratio, 12 to 900, how many employees is being monitored by one safety guy? One is to what? One is to 150? Kasi 12 eh. Hindi pala. One is to... 900, one is to 90? Tama ba?
80.
One is to 80. Alright, anong standard natin? One is to 50, tama?
Ilang sir, 50.
Kaya oh, pa. Ayan. See, that's what I am trying to tell you guys. Right? So that is the end of our first module, which is what we call the introduction to health and safety. So that's the introduction pa lang tayo. Ha? And that is just the introduction. Okay, moving forward to module 2. Any questions, guys? Hope that's clear. Assessing risk, or what we call risk assessment. Okay, let's move forward. Assessing risk. What is risk? What is risk assessment? And how risk assessment is carried out. Okay, this is your project, everybody, huh, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so you're going to submit risk assessment as part of your exam. Okay. I have discussed this for so many times, and I will discuss it again. I will not go to the slides. Let's discuss this as what we have. Do you remember the discussion last week, last Friday? I was the tutor What's that subject? Sino matin ng pinuhod ng ng diploma last week? Ano yung subject natin? Electrical. Electrical safety, right? And then I have tested all of you, and most of you have been my students already, right? And I'm always asking this question, right? What's the hazard of working in a cold environment? For us to be able to go with the basics, for us to be able to understand what is the difference between hazard and risk. Okay? Hazard is anything that has the potential to cause harm. Right? And then risk is the outcome of that harm. Okay. What is the risk? I think I need to go with the live one. Guys, just give me one sec. Let's go with the live one. Okay, so this is the live one. Mas maganda yung live eh. Alright. Okay, here we go. Okay, everybody. On this animation, right, what do you think is the hazard?
Overspeeding, sir.
Overspeeding? Is he overspeeding?
Overspeeding in the passenger car.
Sabi niyo, gabi yung
okay. Let's put it this way, mga bro, ha? Okay. When you say overspeeding, have you seen the dashboard of the car? And is there any indication or sign that the speed should only be, for example, 30 kilometers per hour? So, the idea is, ladies and gentlemen, please don't jump into conclusion, okay? So, you are not seeing the dashboard or how much speed the car's running. So, how could you say that this guy is overspeeding? And there's no indication or no sign or signages, right, that says this road only runs, on this road, okay, you could only run 20 or 30, 40 kilometers. Because if you will you will ask me, you need to justify, right? Once again, what's the hazard on this very short clip or animation? Okay, sabi ni Bro Comini, Bro Comini. Yes, again, hazard is something that has the potential to cause harm. Bro Jeb, go ahead. You're saying something, Bro Jeb?
A chance to collide to another vehicle, sir.
Mm-hmm. That is what?
Hazard, sir.
No. That's a risk, bro. Because the potential of this, yes, that's a risk, right? Okay, let's understand again. Okay, let's analyze. The hazard here, by definition, is something that has the potential to cause harm. So, the thing that has the potential to cause harm here is the car itself. Can the car or does the car have the potential to cause harm to people? Yes or no?
Permission to speak, sir?
So which means, yes, bro, Kent, go ahead.
Yes, sir. For me, sir, the hazard there is the driver itself.
The driver itself. Okay.
Yeah, because he is a student driver. He has the potential to cause harm because of his, he's starting to learn driving.
Okay. So we have two hazards, right? The car and the driver or the student driver, okay, on this image. Okay. So we have two hazards now. So, bro, Ken, what is the risk of driving? Whether you are a student or whether you are a professional driver. What is the risk of driving? What's the risk potential, of driving?
The potential to, for me, sir, it's the potential to lose control of the, what you call that? Yung manubela, sir. And then lose control of the vehicle.
Okay. So that's the risk. Okay, let's put it this way. Again, hazard is either the driver or the car himself. Or the car and the driver himself, right? The risk of driving, okay, whether you're a student or whether you're a professional driver, right? In general, is accident. Okay? So the risk is, let's put it one by one. Ano ba yung implication or pwede mangyari or risk if you are student driver or professional driver? One, pag nakabangga ka, when you hit somebody, injury. Okay? If that is something which is sinamasama ng tama, fatality or death. So that is the risk of driving whether you are a student or whether you are a professional driver. Who among you guys here are drivers? Every day when you are, when we, because I am a driver as well, every day when we are on the car, there's always a risk of us getting injured or us injuring somebody or us hitting a fixed asset or hitting a building or hitting a concrete or hitting something na masisira natin. Isn't that the risk, right?
Yes,
so every day when we are driving, there's always a risk of accident. So if you're going to summarize hazard and risk, risk is the outcome, right, of the hazard. Again, I have asked this for so many times, right? So what is the hazard of working in a cold environment? Most of the people will answer hypothermia. chilblains. Ano yung kay Leonardo? What is that? Hypothermia, right? So most of the people will give me an answer, right? Like those effects or health effects on the person. But my question is, what is the hazard of working in a cold environment? What they don't understand is the cold environment is the hazard because the cold environment has the potential to cause harm. Once again, I did not ask, okay, a question, what is the health effect of a cold environment or working in a cold environment? My question is, what is the hazard of working in a cold environment? And then, what is the risk of working in a what is the risk of working in a cold environment? Potentially, the risk could be ill health. What are those ill health? Hypothermia, chilblains, right? Blah, blah, blah. So again, the most of the problem with health and safety practitioners or officers is that we really don't understand the difference between hazards and risk, which is the very basic, right, of our very basic of our studies. Once again, let's put it this way. work at heights, is it a hazard or is it a risk?
Sir, working at heights, sir, is an activity, sir.
Good. Very good. Mashallah, at least. What is the hazard of working at heights?
False, sir.
False. What is the risk of working at heights?
Physical injury, sir. And chances of death or fatality, sir.
Thank you very much, Bro Jabe. Now, did everybody understood that? Right? Work at heights is an activity. The hazard of work at height is falls because falls has the potential to cause harm. What is the risk of working at heights? Injury. It's either broken bones, it's either fatality, it's either broken neck, it's either broken spine. That is the risk of working on heights or working at heights. I believe that is clear. Sinong medyo nalalabuan? Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
That's the basic. Okay? In other local trainings, you might hear or you might hear, right, that work at heights is a hazard. But honestly, guys, in a higher level of training, like IOS, like NIMBOS, work at the heights is not a hazard. Work at heights is an activity. Now, what is the hazard of working at heights? It's false. Because never working at heights, right, will harm you. Working at heights is a hazard. Some of the people say working at heights is a hazard. How come a working at heights activity is going to be a hazard? No, it's not. It's the falls that will hurt you, right? From heights. It's not the working at heights, the activity. Lalo kung kompleto ka with PPE. Lalo kung may training. Lalo kung may PTW. Lalo kung the equipment that was used, like ladder, like scaffold, was inspected before use. Okay? So I hope, guys, that you understand, right, the difference between hazards and risk. Okay? So that's the very basic, guys, huh? The very basic. Risk here definitely is accident. Yeah, I know me use. There you go. Risk of hitting pedestrian. Okay? Okay, I will not go here, everyone, because this will complicate things. All right. See, it's simple. Hazard is a potential or anything that has the potential to cause harm. Okay, right. This is a hazard. Right. There you go. Hazardous event. Okay. Likelihood, I think this is one of the good things to be discussed. Everybody, look at the background of this. Look at the background of this. And lastly, look at the background of this. Now, we are talking about likelihood. Ayan, so gusto mag-record daw. Okay, ayan. Anyway, you have seen the backgrounds, right? Let's talk about let's talk about okay, let's talk about low, medium, and high. Okay. So which one of this accident is likely or highly likely to happen? Okay, which one is low? Is it here? Is it here? Oh. Is it? Oh, there you go. How likely is it to happen? Okay. Is it here? Is it here? Or is it here? Let's talk about low, medium, and high likelihood. Low likelihood, is it here? Is it here? Or is it here? Chances.
Sir.
Likelihood, right, is the chance. Yes, bro, Jeb. How likely that, is it, sir, in this background? Is it low, medium, or high?
Based on the picture, sir, there's a person walking on that surface. Lahat yun, may tao. So, lahat yun, sir, there's a chance that the hazard event will occur, sir.
Yeah, there's a chance. But which one? Okay, let's identify which one is high likelihood, low likelihood, and medium likelihood. In, sa background project, dito sa nakikita mo ngayon.
Dun sa may kalsada, sir. Dun sa may gutter.
Ito?
Yes, sir.
O, ito. So, ito?
Yes, sir. For me.
So, ano to? Low, medium, or high?
High, sir. For me, sir.
High. So, ano naman, yes, to?
Medium.
Low or medium?
Medium, sir. For me.
Medium. So, medium, high, it's definitely... There's no other choice, so this is low, right?
Yes, right, sir. Project? Yes, sir.
Okay.
Let's go with the low, sir.
Thank you very much. So that is the right answer. The likelihood or the chance of this incident to happen here, right? Or the trip. Let's talk about the trip. Okay. Tripping hazard or trip hazard. How likely is it to happen? In this image or in this background, it is medium likelihood. Why? This is a warehouse. Okay, there are materials in the background, right? So let's say there are 5, 6, 7, 8 people in this warehouse, right or wrong? Few people only, right? So which means, okay, this is medium. The likelihood that of the trip hazard will happen is medium on this background. Here is high, right? The tripping hazard, the likelihood of tripping hazard is high because this is a public area. Street. Lots of people will be here, right? So not only hundreds, maybe thousands, depending on the area. If this is Los Angeles, California, or Nevada, then definitely there are going to be thousands of people who will be walking on the street. And if you have a hole on the street, and definitely hundreds will trip on that. So that's highly likely, right? So the likelihood is very high. And of course, here is just your backyard. So in your backyard, you have a hole like this. So which means how many times you're going to throw garbage right on the backyard? Maybe once or twice in a week. So your chances or the likelihood of you, okay, tripping on that hole is very low. Because you are going at the backyard to throw garbage, right, in just two times, right, in a week. So it's very low. The chances is very low. Correct? Tama na, bro? Okay. So,
yes, sir.
Backyard, yes. Background kay bro, home mini. Okay. Moving forward. Okay, ayan na. I'll let go here. Hazard. Let's identify the hazard here. Everyone. What's the hazard here?
Wet floor, sir.
Why is the hazard? Huh? Wet floor. Wet floor or the water itself? And so what? Okay, now we might not go to our third module today. Let's discuss the third module, right? Tomorrow evening. Our next schedule, which is 6 o'clock, all right, to 10 tomorrow. Okay, because this is very important. Okay, so in this part, everybody, we're gonna be identifying hazards, all right, office, manufacturing, and construction. So what I will do is that I will group you, all right, into how many are you? 41. Right, I will group you into five. Let's make it four. Okay, four, and then the activity will be this. Sorry, three. Let's make it three rather, because the pictures are only three. Okay, so what are you going to do? Okay, so in the remaining time, what everybody will do is that in your group, you're going to allocate one representative. Okay, and that one representative is the one who's going to present, okay, in identifying the hazard. What are those hazards that they have identified? Okay, and we will apply control measures afterwards. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, what I will do is I'm going to divide you once again into three groups, okay, because we have three pictures. Okay, so everybody, before I do that, take a screenshot first, guys, of the picture. Take a screenshot or take a picture through your mobile phone. Everybody?
Done, sir, done.
Done? Okay, next.
Done, sir.
Okay, next is this, manufacturing. So once again, screenshot, take photos on your mobile phone. Done? Okay.
Done, sir.
And next will be this one, okay, construction. So once again, screenshot or mobile phone picture, that will do. So 40 divided by the 3 is going to be 33. And the one group will be 34. Not 34, 13 or 14. And okay, 13 or 14 group members. Okay. So once you're done, okay, so here's the instructions. Instruction once again. You will be allocated into different groups, right? So you will be divided into three. And three groups will have one representative each one of the group. Okay. So what you will do now in the next 30 minutes is that you are going to identify hazards, right, on those images, depending on which group you will be. Okay, you brainstorm, the whole group will brainstorm and identify those hazards. And afterwards, we will check whether you have identified the correct hazards. So the activity will last for 30 minutes. So I will be expecting, and let's be back. I will close the rooms or the breakout rooms, right, by 9:15, right? So 9:15, I will close out the room and we will discuss. I'll start discussion. Okay. So any questions, ladies and gentlemen, before we go with the breakout rooms?
Paano question? Group there.
I will allocate you. It will be automatic. So whatever group, right, you will be allocated, just click join. Okay, so you will see on your screen join group, then you just click copy, join copy, and copy. you will be on that group already. Okay, whenever you're ready, I'm gonna break the rooms, right, into three. Okay, here we go. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Just click again, join, and you will be on that room. There you go. Okay, guys, go now to your respective rooms, please.
Pindutin niyo yung mga bro, yung join.
Join. Go into your specific rooms, everyone. Okay, so who is that?
Hello mga sir. Di natin natanong pala kung anong picture yung sa atin ah.
Ay, oo nga, 3 pictures pala yun. Tapos, aling kaya sa atin doon?
Yung 1, 2, 3 na ba yun? Yung ano? Yung pinakita na, sir? Yung una sa, yung kung number 1, group 1 tayo eh, no?
Group 1 tayo, bro. Room 1.
So, susundin natin yung pagkakasunod-sunod na picture sa office tayo.
Oo, yung sa office, yung sa atin, office.
Ah, yung office. Sino po ba pwedeng mag-ano dito? Kasi naka-cellphone lang ako eh. Pwede pong maging speaker natin mamaya. Anyone, mga sir? I-share ko yung paano ba mag-share dito? Yun lang, walang share. Ano kung masishare?
Baka si Brother Ken, pwede siya.
Sir Ken?
Oh, mga sir. Naka-cellphone lang tinawa ako.
Sino po bang ano dito?
Yung... Bro, ganito ang gawin ninyo, bro. Mayroong isa sa inyo, isulat ninyo sa papel. Kung may papel kayo dyan, isulat ninyo. Based doon sa... Tingnan nyo yun sa GC ninyo, mayroon akong nilagay na... ano na screenshot doon sa risk assessment. So isunod niyo 'yon, halimbawa pull hazard sa hazard pool. Yung katulad ginawa na example, isulat kamay niyo lang kung anong niyo. So kita try ko i-share yung yung picture. Ay wala ako picture number 1. I-post niyo nga sa GC niyo yung picture number 1, yung office. Kasi nasama ako dito sa group ninyo eh. Pero hindi ako kayo yung maggumawa. Guide lang ko.
Post ko bro.
Oh, kita niyo yung picture niyo?
Yes, bro.
Oh, yan.
Kita na, bro.
Meron na po bang magsusulat?
Yung mga pakapipede yung mga nasa bahay lang. Nasa trabaho din kasi ako eh.
Mga pwede po sana magsulat.
Mag-assign kayo ng magiging speaker niyo, siya yung mag-explain. Pero lahat kayo dapat participate kayo sa paggawa para lahat kayo nakaintindi kung ano yung recommendation niyo, ano yung hazard dyan. Okay?
May magsusulat na po ba? Ito yung babae.
Pwede ninyo i-assign si Engineer Kent, si Kuya Kent, mag-speech. Okay. I-share nyo lang yung ginawa ninyo sa papel. Tapos i-share screen lang. I-share screen yan eh. Doon sa GC ninyo, yung ginawa ninyo. I-post nyo sa GC para i-share screen. Tapos i-explain, mayroong mag-explain isa sa member ninyo dyan. Okay, example na yun, nakita niyo yung
octopus connection. Hello?
Sa ilalim ng table mayroong octopus connection. So hazard 'yan.
Electrical hazard.
Ano bang ano diyan? Fire hazard. Karoon ng fire ganun. Octopus connection ng hazard.
Hello po. Master.
Tulad diyan stressful. maaaring ano, work yan kasi kaya ganyan yung tao na stress.
With floor, sir, with floor.
Yan, with ayun, floor.
Ayun yung ano, yung nagbatuhan yung dalawang ano, naghagis ng ano. Hazard.
Pool hazard, yung tao na pumatong hello po, hello sa po. Ano.
Hello, hello. Master, excuse me po. Naririnig po ako?
Yes, bro, sige po.
Kakabalik ko lang po galing sala. Ano na po update? Doon po ako na ano sa doon sa nagtapos sa break time tapos kakabalik ko lang. Ano na po update?
Yan bro. Yan mag-aano kayo, naggo-group kayo. Tapos ngayon, nakapasok ka sa group 1, so minute si group 1 ka ngayon na member. So,
okay.
Ngayon mag-ano kayo diyan. Maghanap kayo ng hazard diyan. Yung kagaya ng ginawa example na ano na ang tawag nun, yung risk assessment, yes. Yan ang yes. Gawin ninyo.
Okay.
So magtulungan kayo, mag-assign kayo sino yung magiging speaker ninyo mamaya. 30 minutes lang yan, dapat magawa ninyo na. Ilan ba ang ano, hazard pinapaano sa inyo?
Wala na ako sinabi, sir.
O sige, 30, kung ilan, 36, yung, kung ilan 30, yung makita 30, ninyo.
Lahat daw ng pwedeng makita eh.
Oo. Oh, yan, actually, kahit 10, kaya nyo i-ano dyan eh. So dapat makaya niyo yan within 30 minutes.
Start na tayo, sir. Meron na po ba magsusunod?
Oh, mag-meeting na kayo, mag-assign na kayo kasi nag-guide lang ako sa inyo, lalabas na ako dito. Mag-assign kayo ng magiging speaker niyo tapos i-ano niyo.
Thank you, sir Ibrahim.
So, na kayo. Okay.
Magsulat kayo kagaya nung ano, yung ano, yung naka-post doon sa GC ninyo na risk assessment. I-ano nyo yun, i-gayahin nyo yun. Ano lang naman, yung nakalagay doon, ano ba nakalagay doon? It's column.
Walid.
Ganun lang, sige na.
Okay. May magsusulat na, sir.
Meron na ako na. Makapit. Oh, ayan, meron na siya magsusulat.
Bubig lang ako.
O mag-share na lang ako ng ano, ng kasi nandito ako sa trabaho, mag-share na lang ako ng mga nakikita ko na hazard.
May magsusulat na, sir.
Meron na bro, magsusulat. Baka nag-aayos lang ng mga pitong paper niya and ballpen. Meron na. May nag-participate, nagpano eh, na siya ng kalitan.
Sige.
Doon sa magsusulat, pagsalita na lang pag ano, pag expect na mag ano, mag-participate yung mga mag-share ng mga nakikita natin dito sa photo. Sabi na lang siya pag-start.
Yung nagsulat ng ano ninyo, picturean nyo lang yan, i-post nyo sa GC ninyo, tapos i-screenshot lang yun namin pag mag-present na kayo.
Tapos so, ano po ba to? Pag halimbawa, nakagawa po yung grupo namin, lahat na po ba kami, pasok na po dun sa ano namin or individual pa din po?
Hindi, kayo lahat po, pasok na po yan sa inyo lahat.
Ah, okay.
Isang group lang kayo. Magpili kayo ng representative na mag-present, mag-explain. Pero tulong-tulong kayo sa paghanap ng hazard at ano yung safety recommendation ninyo dyan at sino ang responsible person. Yung ginawa ni ano trainer ninyo na example. So ano na kayo, sino ang magsulat at sino ang magpipresent para lahat maisulat ka agad.
Meron na daw, sir.
Ilan ba tayo dito?
14 tayo, 14. Ah, bali 13, hindi kasama si Brother Ibrahim.
Okay. Bali.
Let's go na, sir. Ay, ito yung babae na nakatayo dun sa ano, upuan.
Yung kape, naulog yung kape.
Yung kape na nasa...
Itong may hawak ng ano, pwede siyang madulas. Yun yung ano niya, risk niya.
Nagdadala ng...
Wet floor.
Sino ba yung tagasulat? Meron na ba? Pag-mention kung ano, ilan na yung naano mo?
Wait bro, yung hazard ang hanapin ninyo. So, ibig sabihin, huwag nyo na anuhin yung babae na madulas sa dyan sa kape. Ang hazard dyan, yung wet floor.
Wet floor.
Yung wet floor.
Okay.
Sino pa? May na-assign na po ba na tagasulat, ano? Tapos,
sige sir, magsasulat din ako.
Okay, yung magsusulat, paki-mention mo kung alin na yung nasulat mo para ma-ano natin, malista natin kung ano alin pa yung dinasali, ano?
Itong wet floor.
Yes, sabak ko, sir.
Malito sa inyo dito. Bariel, pero kayo na-assign na representative na magsasalita mamaya.
Bariel.
At naka-assign na ba kayo ng ano ng nagsusulat sa hazard?
Master, nag-anap pa, master. Tatlo lang kami naka-ano dito, nag-usap.
Ang tatlo. Ano kayo? Hindi sampo kayo.
Yung iba, eh.
Sampo kayo dito. Siyam pala kayo. Pang sampo ako, siyam kayo.
Ayan,
anong picture kayo? Picture, ano number? Anong picture?
Construction kami, number 3.
Construction na, master.
Construction.
Construction.
I-share ko, ha?
Cellphone lang. Opo.
Pre. Pre. Naka-bullpen niya, pre.
Saan?
Bago masak, pre. Eh, pasulat pa.
Tulat ninyo. Yung hazard mo na. So that yung what is the hazard? Ilagay mo yung hazard sa construction.
Sige, sabihin niyo kung anong nakita yung hazard. Isulat ko.
Yan o, pool. Pool hazard, yung tao na sa taas ng scaffolding o pool hazard yan, walang guardrail yung ano. So yan, pasok yan doon sa ano, example ni Akmat. Kanina. Yan, isa yan sa example sa inyo.
Oh, so, lagay mo yung pool. Lagay mo yung pool, hazard pool. Who might be harmed?
Pull hazard, no guardrail, no pull body harness.
Hindi, what is the hazard? Ilagay mo dun yung pull.
Pull ang hazard, pull.
Pull ang hazard. Tapos yung pull
might be harmed. Yung worker sa ano?
Worker for worker attacks. Ano ba yung electrician o ano?
Lagay nyo, workers again, working at height. Yan ang ano, yung who might be harmed. Workers working at height.
Working, workers working at height. Yan yung ano natin, who might be harmed.
Tapos yung how might people be harmed? Full due to lack of scaffold guard or PPE.
Na, patay, may bullpen.
Daming hazard dyan, kahit 50 na hazard, mano nyo dyan. Ang dami nyan, dapat, ano kayo, marami kayong ma-identify dyan. Tulong-tulong kayo. 30 minutes, 20 minutes na lang, oh. Tagal ninyo.
Bullpen, mawala.
Ang existing control.
Isa lang, isa lang magsulat para hindi kayo, ang iba, maghanap ng hazard. Isa lang yung magsulat. Number one, hazard, ganito. Ito yung recommendation, ito yung who might be harmed, ito yung who is responsible person, scaffold supervisor, lagay nyo, scaffold supervisor and safety officer, ganon. Then,
baka may
ano, isang tao lang ang magsulat. Pagkatapos, picturean nyo yung ano nyo, i-post nyo sa GC ninyo, kasi iba-iba kayong hazard makikita, iba yung sa kabila. So, i-post nyo, after nyo, ano, picturean, i-post sa GC para i-ano namin, i-share screen namin sa training. So, ngayon, yung isang na-assign ninyo kung sino yung mag-present, magbabasa, mag-explain, siya yung mag-explain.
Wala kayong mga bullpen.
Ano yung operator ng grinder, tawag yata ng grinder mga sir, ay wala siyang ano, wala siyang acoustic, wala siyang ano, wala siyang Google. Nakatayo diyan na may hawak na grinder.
Isa,
po.
Sir, isulat niyo yung mga observations
sila. Ito, ganito muna ha. Kasi meron tayong forms. Sundan natin. Una, i-identify natin yung hazard.
Tapos,
sino yung person
na
might be harmed.
Sir, so, isulat mo yung fall, hazard.
Sa una natin, fall ang hazard. Who might be harmed? Workers working at height. Yun yung ano. Who might be harmed? Yung ano pa yung sa form natin?
How might people be harmed?
How
they might people due to lack of scaffold guardrails.
No, meron na no. Meron namang guardrails. Yung wala niya, harness.
Oh, harness, isulat mo.
Hindi, yung existing kasi meron ano, merong guardrails. Meron siyang ano, guardrails. Ang wala sa kanya, yung full body harness.
Oh, sige, iano mo. Might fall due to lack of body
harness.
Mm. Might fall due to lack of harness. Bro, body harness.
Bro, wala siyang guardrail sa ano ha, sa side ha.
Sa gilid, sa side, ano, wala nga ano.
May guardrail, may...
Nakita ko eh, guardrail eh, wala eh.
Ang ano, how might people wala. Be harmed? How might people be harmed? He might fall due to lack of guardrail on the side, and he doesn't have full body harness. He's not wearing full body harness. Control. Guardrail is utilized only on the front side, but on the side there is no guardrail.
Harness also, sir. Harness.
Yung existing risk control measure, meron ng guardrail pero sa unahan lang. But without body harness.
Lang body harness or harness.
So yung likelihood, sa likelihood,
Lima.
Five. So consequence, kasi nasa lima. Taas siya, mas mataas ang consequence, pag nalaglag siya yan, maaaring
mapag- lima din.
Five din.
So 25 yung ano.
Will be 25.
Okay.
Then,
additional control.
Additional controls. Additional controls, guardrail should also utilize on the side area. And wear full body harness.
Pwede. May sulat sila? Sino nagsulat?
Nagsulat
ha? May nagsulat kasi para explain doon mamaya. Tapos, new risk rating natin, yun na yun. Mayroon na tayong ano, likelihood niya. Ano, likelihood.
Five. So, 25 ang risk rating natin. So, additional control natin, yung additional guardrail doon sa side tsaka full body harness. So, ang residual natin, magiging ano na lang, yung likelihood niya, maging 1 na lang. Yan yung 1. 1 and consequence.
Consequence, pwede 3 or 2. Or 2 na lang. Bawa.
Pwedeng 3 or 2.
Pwede 3 or
2. Sabihin natin
3. May nagsulat ba mga sir?
Meron natin nagsulat.
Nakasulat na? Sino nagsulat sa atin? May nagsulat ha?
Sige, what is the hazard?
No, mga bro.
Hazard, fall.
Ha?
Fall.
Then, fall. Who might be hard?
Fall.
Worker working at height.
May isulat yung mga bro. Working at heights.
Then how might the people be harmed?
He might fall due to lack of guardrail on side, and
he might fall.
He might fall
due to lack of scaffold guardrail on side.
And without using full body harness.
Yes, without using full body harness. system is control.
Scaffold guardrail is utilized only on the front side.
Lack of harness, ha? Harness.
How might be people harm? He might fall due to lack of scaffolding guard side. Guardrail side. And no fall body harness.
Yes.
Yes, electricity. Yung ano, may ano po dyan? May ano ba yan? Electricity.
Existing risk control.
Personal perspective.
Oh, anong isulat natin sa existing risk control?
Scaffold guardrail is utilized on front side only.
Scaffold guardrail.
Bro, existing control ang ilagay nyo, install mid rail and top rail. Ganun lang kasimple. Kasi mayroon na yung mid rail and top rail sa side. Oh. Ang wala lang niya diyan sa other side yung tao which is nagtrabaho diyan sa ano. Wala ba yan o wala, di ba?
Wala sa gilid.
Siya? Wala siya sa side.
Yes, sir. Wala.
Yun, wala. Ang ilagay nyo lang, install complete mid rail and top rail. Yan.
Then race rating LCR
5 5 25 likelihood 5 likelihood 5 consequence 5
25
so risk then, rating is 25.
Bro, dapat yung hazard nyo pag i-multiply ninyo nasa 2 lang 3 ganun. Ibig sabihin safe na yung tao kasi mayroon kayo nilagay na ano na hazard control. Sure. Oh, hindi yung 5 times 5 ha, 25, ibig sabihin high risk 'yun. Kaya ninyo nilagyan ng sabi ninyo, ang control ninyo full body harness. Na nawala na ako.
Oh.
Tapos ang residual control ninyo, ang next control ninyo, lagyan ng ano, so ibig sabihin pag nalagyan na yung ng mid rail top rail tapos may full body harness na doon sa sinabi niyo full body harness, ibig sabihin yung likelihood and consequence, like example likelihood niyo is 4 tapos ang consequence niyo is 3, so total 12. So ngayon sa next ano, naglagay kayo ng control measure na install complete mid rail and top rail, so ang magiging likelihood and consequence, bababa na yon, magiging 1 na siya, tapos lagyan nyo ng 2, so 3 na lang. Ibig sabihin, nasa low risk na yung tao. So bumaba na yung ano, kasi nilagyan.
Sa residual, dapat bumaba na kasi meron tayong additional kundok.
Okay.
So ang residual risk natin, sa likelihood 1, tapos ang natin 2.
Disciplines natin to.
1 times 2 equals 2.
Tapos kung ano natin, risk natin to na lang siya kasi multiply siya. Multiply siya.
Action monitored yung ano, safety supervisor, safety officer.
Safety supervisor.
Ang tagal niyo, isa pa lang yata ano niyo, magbe-break na yung room.
Listen na, matatapos na tayo mga bro. Okay na, next na naman. Action monitored when?
Ngayon, Augusto.
Augusto, sige. Sa next hazard naman tayo, doon sa picture naman tayo, asa na yon? Wala na, ma-out na tayo sa room.
Sige lang, mag-ask kayo ng another 10 minutes.
Augusto, ano yung action?
Ano yung bro?
For clarification lang sir, yung activity sir is to identify hazard lang sir, no?
Oo, identify hazard. Okay, sir.
Thank you sir.
Ah, okay.
Thank
you, sir. Okay yung sa atin. Okay. Identify.
Hazard identification lang muna tayo ha. Kasi kung walang hazard, hindi natin ma-identify yung risk. So kailangan muna nating identify yung hazard para para malaman natin kung ano yung risk. Maganda yung IOSH. How do you find the course, by the way, guys?
Challenging, sir.
Challenging.
Nag-enjoy ako sa bagong knowledge.
Anyway, mas gaganda pa yan when we come to accident and incident investigation. Ano? Okay. My intern is gone. Where's Mariam? Mariam, where are you? Mariam? Nawala si Mariam. Nawala yung intern ko. Okay, I believe everybody's here now. Okay. So, Group 1 representative, where are you?
Yes, sino sir.
Po ang representative
here,
ng Group 1? Okay, Jeb.
Yes, sir. I will be the representative, sir.
Okay, so what are the hazards that you have found? Let's do it one by one. How many, by the way, total?
We identify 10 hazards, sir. Dun sa office.
10 hazards. Okay. Yes, can you tell the class what are those 10 hazards that you found?
Yes, sir. There's no need to, ano, sir, display the picture or...
No need.
Okay, sir.
Just mention all the 10.
Yes, sir. We have yung wet floor, sir.
Okay.
Wet floor. And octopus electrical wiring.
Okay.
Yung manual handling, sir, or ergonomic
bro,
hazard.
Just hang on, ha? There's a difference between octopus wiring and overloaded outlets, huh? Just to
yes,
clarify.
Sir.
Okay.
Sir. Octopus yung ano namin, sir. Na ano lang namin.
Octopus wiring, ah.
Then fall hazard, sir.
Okay.
I need to ano ba, sir, specific to sabihin.
No need. Just tell us what.
Okay, sir. Fall hazard, then horse playing or throwing objects, sir.
Nice. Okay.
Strip hazard.
What again?
Strip hazard.
Strips or trip hazard?
Strip, sir. Sa amin. Strip.
Anong ibig sabihin ng strip?
Siguro, slip. Baka slip yan.
Strip hazard, sir. Parang
no
ganun.
Strips.
Slip, sir. Sorry. Sorry. Slip hazard, sir.
Okay.
Yes. And, yung direct sunlight exposure, sir.
Okay.
And improper storage.
Okay.
Yung sir, improper storage kasi may chemical off kami nakita.
Okay.
Hazardous chemical.
Okay.
Then, skip ko yung fall kasi may fall na isa pa. Pero magkaiba kasi yun sa sir. So, next yung last yung stress.
Stress. Okay. Oh.
Yes,
sir. Okay na yan. Ito na.
Yes, sir.
Complete. Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Now, group one, take a picture of this and let's see if what we have written down are correct. So we have one, that is manual handling, electricals, two, horse playing, three, stress, four, right? Coffee on the floor, five, slips and trips, that's the bag, six, sunlight, seven, falls at heights, 8, trips, 9, and 10, that is chemical. Okay? So, mashallah. Nice. At least you have identified, I think, most of the hazards, right? Okay, so you have 10, and we have 10 as well hazards on the image.
Mashallah. So congratulations, Group 1.
Magaling,
number
magaling,
1.
Magaling.
Thank you, sir.
Magaling, Group 1. Okay.
Tama.
So, pwede na mag-safety manager, bro. Marunong na gumawa risk assessment eh. Pwede na mag-safety manager to.
Okay. Mga bro, ito ay sample lang ha, and this will be the same with the others. Okay. Now, Bro Jeb, nasan ka?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Okay. Bro Jeb, let's go to the coffee on the floor. Coffee on the floor. Okay. So the hazard is coffee on the floor. Okay. So what risk will you give to that? Based sa ating calculation. Likelihood from 1 to 5, anong ibibigay mo? Likelihood or chance of somebody slipping on that coffee on the floor? Likelihood. Or chances? 4. Good.
4.
How about consequence? From 1 to 5?
4, sir. Let's say you consider as 4, sir, also.
Okay. So if we're gonna apply that, mga bro, ano? If we're gonna apply that here, okay? Let's put it this way: hazard, coffee on the floor, right? Who might be harmed? Office workers, right? How people might be harmed, okay? So how people might be harmed? Sleeping on the wet floor, right? So existing control, ang ilalagay natin dito, existing control is none. Kasi wala namang control, di ba? Okay. And the likelihood you told us is 4. Consequence is 4. So 4 by 4 is 16. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, kung 16, let's go back sa ating module. Okay. Ito yung ating risk matrix, bro. Right? There you go. Now, this is our risk matrix. Ayan. So, ang ating risk matrix, sa consequence, ayan, likelihood. Yeah. Slips and trips is very, likely. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Okay, nag-mute ako lahat. So, once again, Jeb, paki-unmute mo kasi na may background tayo. Right. Okay, yes, so 4 is likely sa inyong likelihood. And then, when it comes to consequence, you gave 4 as well. So, which means 4, that is major. Right? So, 4 by 4 is 16. So, let's go back. Nasaan na yung ating matrix? Okay, 6 to 9 stop. Okay. Likelihood, consequence, major. Okay, eto na. So, nagpunta ka. So, 4 by 4 is 16. Tama, bro?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, kung 16 yung iyong findings, sa likelihood multiplied by consequence, so which means the coffee on the floor needs urgent action. Ayan. Bro, nag-mute uli ako. Okay. So, ngayon, naintindihan niyo na ba ang risk assessment? Do you understand it? Likelihood multiplied by consequence. So, you end up by 16. So, 4 is your likelihood, 4 is your consequence. Multiplied them by each other, so you will get 16. So 16 or 15 or 16, it means urgent action. Okay, so urgent action, let's go back to your form, risk assessment form. So additional control is clean up. Okay, so if you will clean up the coffee on the floor, the likelihood of somebody sleeping on the floor will be 1. Wala tayong 0. We have no 0. So the lowest is 1. Consequence, no more. Because why? Nobody will sleep. So consequence will be no more, right? Okay? And then 1 by 1 or 1 multiplied by 1 is equals 1. So, which means without the coffee on the floor, you or 1 or 2, no action needed because you have already eliminated the hazard. I hope everybody got the point. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Alam na. So you now know how to do the risk assessment. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'll just take a screenshot of this function. There you go. Okay, moving forward. Let's go with manufacturing. Manufacturing, where are you? Group 2. Who is the representative group 2? Please. Representative group 2. Group 2, where are you? Who are those people in group 2? Let me call them one by one. Edmond, Paliado, John, Jordan, Joseph, Nelson, Raymond San Jose, Season, Taruk, and Berhelio. Where are you guys? Who is your representative?
Mahina lang ang signal eh. Si ayan, Sir Jordan ang aming ano.
Sige, okay, sir. Where's Jordan? 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 Where is bro Jordan? Bro Jordan?
Natanong na, Sir John.
Attention of Jordan. Jordan?
No, sir.
Okay. There you go. Jordan, go ahead. So tell us, what are those hazards that you have identified? How many, by the way, how many hazards have you identified, Jordan?
Sir, sorry, but actually, sir, we identified the hazard of
Paktay.
Double digit.
Okay. Who else, sorry, Jordan, because your line is
double digit. So, sir, gawa ko na yan. Identify ko yung hazard. Pero...
Okay. Group 2, Jordan. Sorry ha. But then again, your line is breaking. So, is there anybody who else, anybody who could take your place to give us the hazards that your group has identified? Jordan, are you using a data or are you using a Wi-Fi? Jordan?
We are both data. Using data.
Okay.
With Nelson.
Okay. I didn't know.
With Nelson.
Nelson. Nelson. Nelson, mas maganda yata yung signal mo. I think you could... I'll be the representative if you are okay with that. Nelson?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
May, please, number please. One, sir, sleep hazard. Because
okay.
The
oil.
It's oil or water.
Yes, yes, it's an oil, okay. Yes.
And then next. The... for clip, driving...
okay.
Same act. Tapos, housekeeping kasi maraming kalat na ano, sleep trips, magiging costo ng sleep trips.
Okay, bro, just a reminder, when you were identifying hazard as housekeeping, kindly include at the first part poor housekeeping, because housekeeping alone will not tell you anything, right? So yes. If you will yes, put poor housekeeping, it's much better. It's understandable. Tama na, bro?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, katabi ko naman si Jordan eh. Si Jordan din ang ano.
Okay, sige, bro. Go ahead. Next. Next hazard, bro. Bro Nelson?
Kasi siya na sir. Kasi na-identify namin kanina kasi yung nasa scaffolding. Kaya hinahanap namin ngayon.
Ba't nagbago ba, bro, ng group? Ano ba nangyari?
Hindi, sir. Kanina, ang pagkakaintindi namin, yung ipipili lang ng isa.
So, ah, okay. Sige lang, no problem, it's okay.
Yun.
Okay, just based on the picture, Bro Nelson, maybe you could just identify hazard, just based on the picture.
Manual handling nung okay. box ba yun? Siguro mayroong may yung isang tao natin, isang employee may sakit.
Okay. Nagpapawisan. Okay.
Yes, and
okay. Anyway, bro, let's go identify the hazard based on the picture. Ipakita ko na sa inyo. I'll show you what are the hazards. Oops, sorry. There you go. So, these are the hazards.
Behavioral.
Okay. In your allocated picture. Okay. So, there you go. So, counting the hazards, we have one. This is manual handling. Sorry, this is manual handling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 hazards. Okay? So total in your image is 11 hazards. Okay? So we have poor housekeeping. Right? We have machine hazard. Okay? We have a biological hazard, right? Biological because the guy is sweating. He's not sick, but he's sweating. And sweating is a biological hazard because of the bacteria which is coming from his sweat, okay? So, what else? Forklift, so the manual handling is included, right? Another there are two biological hazards because if you can see those three guys inside the manufacturing room, all right, they don't wear, they're not wearing any kind of PPE like hairnet, right, like gloves, their shoes, right, that's the normal shoes usually in manufacturing. When you go inside, there's a shoe cover, right? So it's not allowed for you to go inside the manufacturing, especially if that's food, right? To wear right a normal shoe, right? You can wear normal shoe, but be sure there's a cover in it. So these are the hazards, guys, on your allocated picture. Okay. So anyway, so guys, thank you so much for writing down and brainstorming again as a group in identifying hazards. Group 3. Thank you very much, Group 2. Let's go now to Group 3. Group 3, representative, please.
Sabi niyo kasi yan ang atin, mamili na.
It's fine, bro. It's okay. Now, let's see what you have written down is correct based on what the Group 3 will say. Group 3, let me call on Group 3. Group 3. Badrudin. Edward.
Sige, ako lang, sir. Edward, sir. Opo, sir.
Go ahead. So, what have you found?
Base sa akin na obserbaran, sir, meron akong siyam na na-obserbaran.
Okay, go ahead.
Working at height without full body harness.
Mm-hmm.
Then scaffolding with on the side without top rail and mid rail.
Okay.
Stored heavy material on the working scaffolding platform.
jackhammer, doing jackhammer without the earmuff.
Earmuff.
Then line of fire below the backhoe.
Line of what?
Line of fire sa ilalim ng backhoe, sir.
Anong ibig mo sabihin sa line of fire?
May baka may may buhangin yung ano yung bako. Ano siya, mabagsakan siya ba? Sa ilalim.
Falling materials.
Oh.
Okay, falling materials or falling debris. Okay.
Manual handling, sir.
Okay.
Nagka-cutting ng ano, cutting of wood without full face shield or PPEs.
Uh-huh.
Excavation without barrier.
Uh-huh.
Cable laying without protection.
Uh-huh.
Yan lang ang aking obserbaran, sir.
Okay. Isa-isahin natin, ha. Anong sabi mo do bro doon sa excavation ulit? Para ano ulit ang sabi mo?
Without barrier, sir.
Okay, excavation without barrier?
Opo.
Okay, 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 okay. Okay, thank you very much for that Narciso. Okay, let me give you what are the hazards. All right, thank you very much Edward. Okay. Anyway, the reason why you are here is for you to understand, right? The training, and of course, for you to learn. Okay. Once again, the task, the activity is for you to identify hazards and not for you to identify control measures.
Okay.
All right, guys, those are two different things. You were tasked to identify hazards, okay, and not the control measures. Now, let me give you one example. Edward, excavation. Without barricade, am I correct?
Tama po, tama po.
Okay. So excavation, bro, right? Is it a hazard? Excavation?
Opo,
or
tama po.
Is it an activity?
Activity po, activity.
Okay. So, since the excavation produces hole on the ground, so the hazard there, something that has the potential to cause harm, is not the activity, but it's the faults on the excavated area. Tama, bro? Which is the trench.
Tama po. Yung lalim. Makamahulog.
Okay. So, once again, ha? Learn to understand and analyze, mga bro, the situation, and always bear in mind the definition of hazard. Okay? Hazard is different from risk. Risk is different from control measures like PPE. So the hazard there is the falls right on trench or falls on the excavated area. Okay, so that is the hazard. Falls has the potential to cause harm. Even on the scaffolding, the person or the guy on the top of the scaffold, all right, has no harness. But again, the activity is for you to identify hazard, not to identify control measures. Right, so the hazard here once again is false. Right, so I have heard. Right, so the this person is using a jackhammer without. What's that, bro Edward? Without
earmuff.
Earmuff.
Ear protection.
Again, bro Edward, what is the hazard in this specific activity, which is drilling? What is the hazard?
High noise and vibration.
Okay, so the activity or the activity is drilling. The hazard is noise and of course vibration. Okay, so the earmuff is a control measure for noise. Okay, and the vibration. Okay, the hazard is the vibration and the control measure for that. There are actually lots. Vibration gloves. Right, preventive maintenance of the machine. So those are the control measures for those. But once again, the activity or the task was to identify hazards. So it's okay that you have identified the control measures, that's really good. At least you know what to do. But then again, the reason why I'm trying to tell you not to go beyond what you are seeing or beyond what's the question is because in the international trainings or examination, like most specific NIBOS, right? If the question is just asking you for a hazard, don't give a control measure. Because they are not asking for a control measure. The same with the form, guys, the same with the form. Please be reminded of this. Let me tell you one thing, okay? It says here what's the hazard. So kung ano lang yung itanong ng form, that's the only answer that you will give. If the form asks you who might be harmed, specific, give the person who might be harmed. Office worker, electrician, carpenter, right? Operator, driver, right? Be specific. Hey, the form is asking for you how. Remember, guys, the question, how? Papaano? Because most of the students that I had before, they are writing down story, right? In how they might be harmed. And it does not answer really the question how. So be careful with those guys, huh? Okay? Existing control. Okay, so whatever is the question or whatever the table is asking for, analyze it and give what really this form wants. Huwag na magpaligoy-ligoy. Ano mga bro? Straight to the point. Straightforward. Whatever the question is, just give them the answer, whatever it is. Alright? So, again, the purpose of that is for us, FASPE, alright, to prepare you for international trainings like level 3 and level 6. Because those trainings, the exams there are really complicated. Your understanding and comprehension of analyzing question will be tested. Like, for example, the one I just gave you earlier. What is the hazard of working in a cold environment? Most of you will tell me health effects. Again, listen to the question. The question is, what is the hazard of working in a cold environment? You didn't hear me ask for a side effect or health effect of working in a cold environment. You did not. Wala kayong narinig na tinanong kung ano yung sakit na makukuha mo pag nagtrabaho ka sa malamig na lugar. Ang tinatanong ko, ano yung hazard? Ano yung pwede makasakit sa tao? Okay? And that is the cold environment itself. Okay? So once again, be careful with those. Okay? So again, you are here to learn. You are here to know what are the right thing to do, right reporting, how to identify hazards. Okay, so that's why that is what we're studying, right? This time is the right time for you to make mistakes, right? So, bro, Edward, hopefully hindi ka na offend, right? Doon sa sinabi ko. Okay, so again, for group 3, right, we are just discussing. Because you are here to learn. You wanted to learn. So that's why I'm teaching you, right, what are the right things to do. Okay? Mm-hmm. If you're asked of the hazard, just go with the hazard. If you're asked for the risk, go with the risk. Write down what the risks are. Okay? So analyze, comprehend, right, and understand, okay, what is the question or whatever the instruction would be. Okay? So those are the hazards or what you are seeing right now. Right on the pictures are the hazards right on this picture or in this image. Group 3, are we okay? Group 3.
Ayos lang, sir.
Oh, group 3, okay lang kayo, thank ha? You, no hard feelings, ha?
Maganda yan, sir, para malaman talaga yung totoo.
Yes, okay. So that's the reason why you are here. Again, I'm not here to play. We are not here to play. We are not here to give a praise to somebody or whatever, but we are here to learn. So that's why you are learning. Okay, so whatever misfortune of one of yung hindi naintindihan, we will itatama natin. Okay, we'll make sure that you understand that we are going to be on the same page. Okay, so
bro Ahmad, dagdag ko lang konti, bro.
Sige, bro.
Mga bro,
Yung pag-identify ng hazard, napaka importante po yan kasi itong risk assessment kasi is preparation nyo yan pag kumuha kayo ng nibos. Okay, yung managing safety or safely na diniscuss ni Bro Ahmad kanina, yung mga duties and responsibility, yung legal, moral, and financial, which is lalabas din yan sa nibos. Okay, yes. Nandun din yan. Kung paano niyo sagutan ni boss depending on the scenario. And then paano niyo explain yung management responsibility, mga ganun. Then paggawa ng risk assessment, kailangan be specific kayo doon sa hazard. Tandaan niyo, katulad ng sinasabi ni bro, which is a good ito. Sabi ni bro, laying of electrical cable on the ground without So that is not a hazard. Yung sinasabi. So that is a justification ng scenario ng cable. Okay? Yung cable, electrical cable diyan is unprotected, 'di ba? Yung electrical cable ang hazard diyan na unprotected. So ngayon pag sinabi natin, ano bang sinabi mo unprotected? So ano ang gagawin ngayon? Dalawa. Ito lang tandaan niyo, bro. Yung control measure i-apply niyo kaagad yung administrative control, engineering control, elimination, PPE. So diyan kayo focus sa control measure na ano ninyo. Yung substitution diyan, yung hierarchy of control diyan kayo focus. Pag sinabing PPE o katulad nung nasa scaffolding on the platform. So anong PPE diyan? Eh di yung full body harness. Tapos engineering control. Lagyan ng top rail at mid rail, 'di ba? So 'yun ang dalawang control, isa ang engineering control, isa yung isa ang PPE. So nasa loob ng hierarchy of control ang dapat ninyo ilagay na control measure doon sa hazard na na-identify niyo. But be specific the hazard kasi sinabi ni Bro Ahmad, minsan dito talaga nagkamali paggawa ng risk assessment. Instead hazard ang nilagay, parang may kasamang control measure yung statement doon sa hazard. So, nandun yung hazard, kasama naman yung statement. Sabi na working jackhammer without air plug or air map. So, nagkombinasyon yung yung hazard at saka yung control measure. So, be specific. Yun ang maganda tong na to. Napaka ako, kahit ako, hindi ko pa ng gusto ma-perfect tong knowledge na to But alhamdulillah, due to this training, nadagdagan ng gusto or na yung natin, yung isipan natin kung paano talaga ang tamang paggawa ng risk assessment. Okay mga bro, good luck again. Thank you bro Ahmad.
Okay, thank you very much Master. Okay, so... Ayan na, naiintindihan na po natin. We have understood already how to identify hazard and be sure that you put right the right information on the right table. Okay, mga bro? Because one mistake, listen, if you have a mistake already, let's say for example, you have mistakenly identified right the hazard. Okay, let's say for example, right, let's put it this way, okay? So what is the hazard? Let's go with the guy in top of the scaffold. No guardrail and harness. Okay? So most of the safety, right? They will say, "Yes, bro, that is a hazard." Okay, question. Okay, bro Edward. Okay, bro Edward. No guardrail and harness. Hazard?
Guardrail, sir. No, hazard.
No guardrail. Hazard?
Opo.
Okay.
No.
Samuel, no guardrail. Is it a hazard?
No, sir, no.
No. So, anong pwede natin ilagay doon sa hazard? Doon sa taong nasa scaffold?
Installed guardrail.
Ha? Installed guardrail. So, you are referring again to control measures? Okay.
All.
Okay, good. Bro, mga bro, again, reminder, the hazard is false, right? Due to missing a guardrail and full body harness. Mas kapanipaniwala to bro, ano? Okay? False. The main hazard is false because false, right, has the potential to cause harm. A scaffold, okay, without or missing mid-rail or top-rail is not a hazard because it's only missing. Okay? Ito bro ha, tanggalin natin yung false. Okay? Let's say for example, right, I will remove false and the only information written here is missing guardrail. How could be or how could a missing guardrail be a hazard if it is missing? Try to understand, try to analyze, and try to comprehend. What can a missing guardrail do to hurt you or to hurt the worker? Nothing. Right? But falls could hurt the person who's on top of the scaffold. So, I will go back. The hazard here is falls, anything or something that has the potential to cause harm, okay, due to missing guardrail. The reason why the person will fall is because of the missing guardrail. And of course, because of the missing personal protective equipment, which is the full body harness. Once again, guys, ha, missing guardrail is not a hazard. Okay? That is the reason why for this person to fall. And fall is the hazard. Because fall is something or anything that has the potential to cause harm. Okay? Hope that is clear. Maliwanag na ba, bro? Okay? Cable on the floor. The hazard here is definitely the cable. Yes. But then again, if you're gonna look, analyze, the cable is really not the hazard. The hazard here is slip, trips, and falls due to the cable on the floor. Tama ba? Or mali? If I will just tell you, what is the hazard? The hazard is the wire on the floor. What if the wire is naka-align? What if the wire is nandoon sa gilid? Could it be a hazard? No, it's not. It's just a cable on the floor. The cable will not hurt you because it's just a cable on the floor. But if you will tell me, slips and trips because of mist, ang tawag doon?
Improper arrangement.
Oh, improper. Improper arrangement or improper position. Yun. Improper positioning of the cable. Or yun, I got the term. Trailing. Okay? The term is trailing cable. Slips and trips is the hazard. What's the reason? Because of the trailing cable. The trailing cable on the floor is not a hazard. Right? What could hurt the people is the slips and trips on that trailing cable on the floor. Okay? Naintindihan ba? Everybody understood? Okay. You have said earlier, once again, huh? Overloaded, let's say, overloaded scaffold how can an overloaded scaffold hurt you? And how do you know that this is overloaded? Did you calculate the load capacity of the scaffold? No. You only just decided that this is a hazard based on what you see. But the real hazard here is the potential collapse of the scaffold. Okay? Why? Because of the incomplete scaffold components. That is what's clear. Right? And the erection of the scaffold. Right? Erection, when the scaffold was erected, there is a plate here. Erection of the scaffold over a hole on the ground. So the hazard here is collapse, right? And the not the overloaded, right? Overloaded scaffold, right? Because then again, you don't know if that's overloaded or not. Ni hindi nga nabali yung platform mo. Ni hindi bumaba yung platform. So how could you say that this is a hazard? The overloaded, how do you say it's overloaded? How could you justify it's overloaded? Okay? But the hazard here is, again, collapse of the scaffold. Can collapse of the scaffold hurt the people? Yes. When it collapses, it could hurt, right, the person who is holding the shovel. It could hurt the people or the person who is cutting the wood. It could hurt the people, the engineers, the guy walking manual handling, the guy with the hollow blocks, right? They could be hurt, right, when the scaffold collapse. So the hazard is the collapse of the scaffold, right? Why? Okay, let's say that you have calculation of the load. You say it's overloaded when you calculate. Yes, you can say collapse of the scaffold because of the overloaded, because it's overloaded. Because you have the calculation. But if you don't have the calculation, you cannot consider this, or I will not believe you that this is overloaded. Not unless you give me a calculation. The scaffold will collapse. You know what? Because of the insufficient or a missing components of the scaffold, and then it was erected on top of a hole. It was only covered by a metal sheet. Look at that. So see the difference?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Again, I hope you understand everything that we have discussed, right? So use that information, everybody, right, in future, and make sure that what you identified is really a hazard. Remember, hazard, simply. Something or anything that has the potential to cause harm. Manual handling can cause harm. Yes, look at the guy, right? They're holding the hollow blocks. It could hurt his back, right? The guy using the shovel, it could hurt his back. So yeah, manual handling is a hazard. It is something that has the potential to cause harm. Right? The trailing cable or electrical cable on the ground is not a hazard. It's just trailing the cable. It will not hurt you, not unless you trip and falls. So the hazard is trip and falls, or slips and falls, or trips and falls because of the cable on the floor or trailing cable on the floor. But the trailing cable itself is not a hazard. It will not hurt you, not unless you go there, you walk there, and you slip. Tama ba? If you see a cable like this, you will say it's a hazard. How could it be hazard if nobody will walk on it, if nobody will trip on it? Okay? Slips, trips, and falls due to trailing cable on the floor. So that's how you write it down. Hazard, trailing cable on the floor. How could it hurt you? By slipping and tripping. So the hazard is the slip and trip. Okay? Because that's the one that could hurt you. Not the cable. Right. Okay. Anything else you wanted to ask? Clarifications, everyone. Okay, let's continue discussing, right, once again, the other module tomorrow. We'll make it fast, okay, because those are easy modules. So no worries about it. We can finish that in less than an hour, right? One slide. Maybe 20, 30 minutes, each of the slides. Nagpapatagal lang is yung activity. Okay, it's 9:56. It's 10 o'clock already, 4 minutes to 10. I think we have to call it a day. Right? Thank you very much, everybody, for your time, for attending this course. Right? For those who are going to be attending the course tomorrow, excavation and trenching, okay, I will as well be the tutor tomorrow at 8 o'clock in the morning. Right? So see you tomorrow on the diploma class. Right? And in the evening, 6 o'clock, once again, will be the continuation of our class, which is IS Managing Safety.
Thank you so much.
Everybody, question, clarification, any other violent reaction? Nothing? Okay, mga bro, once again, I am sorry for the language I am using because once again, we have somebody here with us, which is my intern, Miss Mariam. I want her to understand fully, right, the concept of the training. Okay, so Mariam, I hope you're still there. All right, so Mariam is there. All right, so Mariam, did you enjoy the class? Did you learn? Where is she? Okay, anyway, I'll. Okay, good to hear that you have learned something from this class. All right, so guys, I thank you very much for your attendance. All right, so I'll see you again tomorrow. All right, it's either in the morning or in the afternoon.
Thank you, Sir Rolly. Okay, so, thank you po.
Thank you, sir. Good night, everyone. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Master.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Thank you, bro.
Master, thank you, insight.
Matulog na maaga yung mga ano, kasi may klase tayo bukas, ha? Para sa diploma naman.
Okay, sige. Ako yung alole bukas, alas 8.
Oo, si Sir pala ulit.
Huwag kayo magsasawa, ha? Magsasawa kayo sa mukha ko, si Sir Rolly naman. Anyway. Sige, bro. Good night. Mag-exit na ako, Master, ha?
Okay. Good night sa lahat.
Sige, bro. Salamat, Sir.